one record is book one. Type book, books is record. Okay, so we are declaring a one record. Title, author, subject, book ID, book one and book two. Okay. So here begin book title is C programming. Book one author. So we are defining two record. Okay. So in a two record, we are defining title, author and subject and book ID. Book one title is C programming. Book one author is R Sharma. Book one subject is C programming tutorial. Then book one book ID is 6436. Okay. We're defining book ID, subject, author and title. It is for book one record. And book two record is what? Now book two dot title is PL billing. Okay, then book two dot author is M Sao. Book two dot subject is telecom billing tutorial. Then book two book ID is 9078. It is a record. We are defining a record. Okay, then here book two dot title, then after storing the value in the record, we're using book title, book one dot title, then book one author, book one dot author. Similar way it is printing you for the book two. Okay, so here we're defining the two declaration of your record. This is just an example of it. So how the record is defined. And telephone billing. Clear? So Mali, it is clear?
Yes, sir. Netlab.
Yes, example ta. Go for the second example. Next example is what? Associative array index. So before that we go to the chapter. Associative array index by table. An associative array is a PLSQL collection with two columns. It contains the two columns. One is primary key of an integer or string data type, column of scalar or record data type. So here it contains the two things. One is an associative array of a PLSQL data type. Associative array of PLSQL data type, and it contains a primary key of integer, which is stored the key with another. It contains a value. ma'am, associative array is a type of PLSQL collection. It is a composite data type and is user defined. It is a user defined data type. Associative array are the set of key and value pair. It contains the key and value pair. They can store the data using primary key. The primary key value as index, where the key value are not necessarily sequential. Associative array are also known as index by table. It call as index by table. Associative array have only two columns, neither of which can be named. The first column of integer or string type act as a primary key. The second column of scalar or record type it hold the value. The first column contain the integer and string type, which is contain the integer and string value. Second contain the scalar or record data type. Okay, so it is a associative array which is contain the key as well as the value. So throw the key, you can get your value. Take the photo. Understood this one? Yeah, associative array.
Yes.
It contains the unique key. Okay, so like it is having a key value which is a unique, like index number or primary key that you can say. This contains a unique key, associative array. It contains the unique key that can be a numeric or either binary, integer or PLS integer. These two numeric data type require less storage than the number. It contains a less storage value, and arithmetic operation on this data type are faster than the number of arithmetic. They are cat 2 or 1 of the subtype. Value column. The value column can be either a scalar data type or record data type. Scalar data type which hold only one value. A record data type which store a particular row or multiple data. Other characteristic is an associative array is not populated at the time of declaration. So at the time of declaration, you cannot populate it. Then it contain no key or value, and you cannot initialize associative array in its declaration. So at the time of declaration, you cannot initialize it. So that an explicit executable statement is required. So like the size of the database table is not constrained, it is not fixed. The similar way, associative array is not fixed. It is dynamically, you can grow the value. First salary, each table of keyword is used for defining associative array, which is create a virtual table here, and it is retrieve the value through the index by column. Then we are adding the value in the array in associative array index. Okay, the key is Rajnish, Meenakshi, Martin, James, and value is, these are the value we are storing. Then it will indicating the first element by using first keyword. So when you are using first, it is indicating the first value, while name is not null. Okay, so still you are having the value in this loop in the salary list. It will retrieve all the name and salary. And cursor is moving to the next slide. Clear?
Yes, sir.
In a associative array, we are using index by table method. In a index by table method, we have like exist, count, first, last, prior, next, delete. So these are the different method that we are using. Exist method, count method, first, last, prior, next and delete. What is the work of exist? Exist is return true if nth element in the associative array is exist. Means if your last element is present, so it is return you true. Count return the count number of element in the associative array. First return the first index number in the associative array. Last return the last index number of associative array. Prior return the index number that precedes the index in the associative array. Next is it is moving to the next element. Then delete it is remove all the element from the associative array. Delete n removing nth element of the associative array. Delete m to n it is deleting the element for the specific point. It is what point time means 2 to 3. Okay, so for removing the element for the specific position m to n is.
Yes, sir.
In the next class, we go for this index by table example. Okay. 6.2.